What's up, guys? This is Chris, John, and Reg, and this is Breaking Truth, where we seek truth in everyday life.
First and foremost, we just want to thank you guys so much.
Yes.
For all the support and love you've shown us for our first few videos. This is just the beginning, like we've mentioned before. We're just on this journey together, and we so appreciate it. We ask that you would continue that support, continue
Absolutely.
That love, continue liking and checking out. We definitely have more content coming to you guys, and this is more starting right now.
To kick us off for the second video, Chris has got the first segment. So, Chris, what do you got for us today, man?
We got something very current today.
Okay.
As you heard, Kanye actually is running for president, right?
Oh,
he declared he wants to put his card in the race.
There's a lot of mixed feelings around that.
See, what I've heard is that it's kind of a publicity stunt to because technically, I don't think he can actually run.
Right.
He hasn't filled out the proper paperwork.
Elections are in November.
Yeah, I think it might be too late for him. So
Kanye has come a long way.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
We gotta see
the last just the last 12 months, right? You just look back, so much has changed.
Yeah, for sure.
Absolutely. His music has evolved.
Kanye is under the microscope as well, right?
Right.
As one of the biggest artists of all time. He's under scrutiny essentially. Like any little mistake he makes through the process, like right when we came to Christ and we first started out,
exactly,
we all had our stumbles, we all had our transition phases. So his is just out in the public.
If the microscope was on us, right, if the lenses were on us, then how many things would have came out,
and
how
the
many
lens.
People would have and how many people would have pointed fingers at us?
Yeah.
A whole lot, because you're gonna make your mistakes while you're in process,
right?
You know, but nobody's watching, so it's like, you know, it doesn't really affect us that much.
That aside, like Kanye just recently dropped something fresh. It's a new single, right? What's the name of the song?
Wash Us With The Blood, I believe.
Wash Us With The Blood.
Is it Wash Us With The Blood or Wash Us In The Blood?
We just know there's blood involved.
Wash Us In The Blood is the name.
Wash Us In The Blood. Wash Us In The Blood.
Travis Scott.
Let's see what he has for us.
Let's do it.
Did you guys see that video before? I remember seeing that video before.
I don't recall.
In the beginning, it was a white police officer. He kind of grabbed or pushed one of the protesters who was black, and then the black police officer kind of jumped in and was "Don't touch him! Don't touch him!" And he kind of backed, and she was pushing up on him. So I remember seeing that separately.
Okay, no, I never.
Yeah, just want to point that out.
Have you guys ever seen that movie, The Last Dragon?
Nope.
By Bruce Leroy.
Bruce Leroy.
Yes.
It sounds familiar, but no.
Bruce Leroy.
I feel like I'm alone.
Call sign, I'm all alone. There's no one here beside me.
In this.
There's a generational gap here.
Yes, there's a big generational gap. That's a classic. That's one of the first DVDs I got when DVD first came out. It's The Last Dragon.
You just dated yourself, bro.
I don't care. Listen.
What does that do?
This guy looks like Shogun from that show. I'm a little confused by this shot right here. I don't know who he is. I don't know if he's supposed to be an artist, or maybe, I don't know if he's trying to portray him as a pimp, or I don't know what it is, but it's one of the shots that I'm a little confused about in the video.
I don't know who that guy is.
Yeah.
All right. Let's keep going.
Rain on one more. Rain come, shine, come, rain, come on. South side, let it bang. Outside, let it rain. Rain down on the pain. Rain down on the slain. Rain down for my mom. Rain down on the farm.
Shower us with your love.
Wash us in the blood.
We need a sense of this.
No, I grew up in the mud. The top is not enough.
Oh, he put him to sleep.
Wash us in the blood. Wash us in the blood. Whole life being thugs. No choice in the drugs. South side what it does.
What do you guys think about the imagery so far?
There's a lot going on. It's like jumping to and from different things. I saw a scene from Kanye's concert. Obviously, that kid got knocked out cold. You guys saw that.
To me, I'm seeing like things in the world that, you know, like the problems that are going on in the world. It looked like some like people with the coronavirus, people fighting, some twerking going on. Right.
I mean, right. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it seems like he's trying to show everything that's going on in the world, mm-hmm. like all the negative stuff and all the things that we're into. And if you hear the chorus, he's saying wash us with the blood. So, you know, I just have this sense that he's just trying to show us that that's the answer, mm-hmm. you know, that with all this, everything that's going on, like is a prayer to God, almost like, hey, Lord, wash us with the blood, because look what's going on in the world.
Right.
Right, let's keep watching. Let it off, set it off. Execution 30 states. 30 states still execute. Thou should not kill, I should not spill. Next tales at the rendezvous. We dodge your time in the federal. Squad box you in like a sectional.
I wonder if there's any significance to the names in like the GTA footage. It said like Andrea something. It had like names. I wonder if there's like
Didn't peep that.
I didn't notice that either.
Yeah, like there was names on it.
Hey, those people have you noticed that Travis Scott did not curse?
I did notice that, yeah.
I noticed that, yes.
That might have been a requirement.
I did peep. He was smoking.
He was smoking.
But he but didn't curse.
He didn't curse.
Still a right. PG song. And they trying to control, yeah. They want me to calm down. They don't want me to Kanye. They don't want Kanye to be Kanye. They want to sign a fake Kanye. They trying to sign a calm, yeah. That's right, I call him calm, yeah. But don't take me the wrong way. But don't take me the... That's New York City right now with all them fireworks.
Bro, those fireworks are out of hand.
That is what this is very accurate to today. The wrong way, because God took me a long way. They want to edit the interviews. They want to take it to interludes. Cut a whole sentence to interludes. You know that it's fake if it's in the news. So I let it fly when I'm in the booth. The devil a lying, I've been the truth. Living because nobody living and nobody getting it. Doing a different rank. Rain down on. Okay,
oh, no.
Ran over like 50 people right there.
Wait, hold on. Yo.
So I peeped, you peeped what he said?
No, what he said?
Something about controlling the narrative.
Right, right. Do you guys think that he is being censored?
Who, Kanye?
Yeah.
Like in this song? Or do you mean in general? It's probably because of the imagery, people fighting.
But it's definitely adult content.
Right, right. But I don't get it because there's a lot of other videos out there, like, you know, like a 6ix9ine video or like, you know, one of those gangster videos that you see a lot of violence, a lot of cursing and a lot of, you know, and profanity. It's not age restricted.
Mm. Right.
You know, but this one is age restricted. I'm trying to figure out why.
So we had a little mishap. We weren't recording pretty much from the last thing you saw onward. We had a whole nice little conversation. We just watched the end of the video. That was really it. Let's talk about the video.
So what do you guys thought overall?
I thought it was pretty interesting, like the way he depicts images, and it the overall tone of it was very Kanye like. I think it aligned with him pretty well.
I can agree. A lot of the visuals are a little disturbing, but it's realistic. A lot of the visuals are actual, you know, raw footage of everything that's going on right now. And it is disturbing, you know, because you know, it's a lot of craziness and chaos that we're going through right now. Being washed by his blood, that's the answer. And I like it. A lot of people might not understand the whole concept of that, but it is gonna make people want to look into it.
Yeah, for sure.
And I think that's the most important part.
That just made like a switch go off in my mind. What we heard in the video, the part with they want the calm Ye, right? And they don't want the real Kanye. It's very interesting because also shortly after that, he mentions that there's a controlling of the narrative. They want to control the content in a sense. And what that just made me think of just now, Chris, is it's almost that social media effect, right? Where when you are... When eyes are on you, you want to sort of portray a very clean cut, very nice looking. Like on Facebook, everyone puts the nice photos out there. Everything is painted so pretty. But I think Kanye is sort of pulling the curtain back so that people can see what's going on like the ground level. That disturbing imagery is the reality, right?
Right.
That's what's happening on a day-to-day basis. And Kanye is really just showing us why we need to be washed in the blood, right?
Actually made me think, do you guys ever think about, like, so we live in a world now and in a society where everything is being recorded at, like, at all times. Whatever happens, the first thing people do is pull out their camera, their phones, and record it, right? And with that comes a lot of imagery now, right? With social media, Instagram, right. Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, all the social media platforms. And we're constantly bombarded with this imagery of, like, you know, fights, you know, accidents, like that car running over people. And we're just constantly being fed this. It makes me think, like, what effect that has on the human mind in, compared to past times where we weren't always watching that. Like, we weren't always exposed to that. It was really pretty much like the news. But now we're just constantly bombarded with these images. And it's created, I think, like, a sense of normalcy now. Like, right. People just scroll past this stuff, like violent acts and those kind of things. Like, it's nothing. We're just, like, kind of numb to it and immune right. to it now. It's got to have some kind of psychological effect.
It does. It affects your spirit.
Yeah.
You know, even me, when I go on social media and I constantly look at these negative images and it's just, you know, you get overwhelmed. And sometimes I don't even want to go on because I know it just depressed me. Mm-hmm. You know, it brings my spirit down.
I think that's a perfect way to talk about. I think that phrase, right, wash us in the blood. We're gonna take that a step further. We're actually gonna dedicate a bonus video directly to that phrase in and of itself. And of course, it's inspired from this song. There's a lot to be said about that. There's a lot of biblical principles that we want to talk about and sort of unwrap for you guys. So stay tuned for that.
And now we're gonna be transitioning right to our next segment.
I'm excited about this one.
Yeah, no, this is gonna be cool. It's gonna be interesting. We're gonna be doing a couple of science experiments.
Nice.
Right. Just very simple, very basic, but they should be pretty cool. So
this is your thing, John. So you're gonna you gotta take us through it. Me and Chris are gonna be.
I got you.
Your assistants.
I got you. that is my field. I enjoy science, biology, chemistry. That's my thing. So yeah, I'll be walking you guys through some experiments.
Absolutely walk me, because I failed in physics.
No, that's school. The thing. We might fail. This is our first time doing it. So
yeah, so there is a possibility that none of this turns out the way we expected it.
Possibly.
So if you are gonna try this at home, just keep in mind that we don't even know exactly if this is gonna come out perfectly. So
We'll see.
Let's
let's go down to the lab.
Let's go to the lab.
All right.